What's up, surveillors? Dropping another video, DJ Khaled, Popstar featuring Drake. And just like any video in this carnival of a world we live in, it's heavily coded. So let's just get straight into it. Alright, so check this out. Drake's chain is literally the key to understanding what this entire music video is about, because the chain is a message within itself. So if you look at the chain, it's a key joint with an owl. So let's go to the Element Encyclopedia of Secret Sciences Symbols and find the word key. The key or clavicle is symbolic of access to something that has been hitherto kept hidden or which is a secret. However, keys are used for locking as well as for unlocking, and deities that are depicted holding keys, for example, may symbolize the need to keep something private or occluded. A key need not to be a physical object, and the act of unlocking is not restricted to mundane artifacts. A code, for example, may hold the key to understanding a secret language or cipher. So the key is symbolic of having access to something that is hidden, or that which is secret. So what's the significance of the owl? The Italian word for owl, strix or strega, also means witch, and this provides a heavy hint about one's aspect of the bird's symbolic meaning. Because the owl is nocturnal, it means it has access to covert information, occult knowledge, and secrets. So not only does the key represent secrets, or that which is hidden, but the owl also represents occult knowledge, secrets, and covert information. Stuff that you're not supposed to know, unless you're initiated. The idea that the owl has access to information denied mere mortals is further underlined by the fact that the bird can swivel its head an astonishing 270 degrees. Quite literally, the bird can see behind itself. And in the book, The Secret Teachings of All Ages by Manly P. Hall, it says the nocturnal birds were appropriate symbols for both sorcery and secret divine sciences. Sorcery because black magic cannot function in the light of truth, day, and is powerful only when surrounded by ignorance, night. And the divine sciences because those possessing the arcana are able to see through the darkness of ignorance and materiality. Owls and bats were consequently often associated with either witchcraft or wisdom. So Drake is covertly telling you, he's well acquainted with occult knowledge and has wisdom and understanding of how you truly become a celebrity, how you truly become a star, or in his case, a pop star, the best kind of celebrity. And who better to pick the star in a music video called Popstar than an actual pop star? I want this drink, yeah, and another one, yeah, and I'm troublesome, yeah. I'm a pop star, but this shit ain't bubblegum, yeah. Now look at this. Notice how these two females are damn near always with him in this music video. Why is that? Pillars are sometimes used in pop culture for reasons other than decorative purposes to take on an esoteric meaning. The act standing between or going through pillars symbolically represent transformation or initiation and can be found in instances such as Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. The cover of the first book of the Harry Potter series, where he discovers he is a wizard, his initiation is visually portrayed as him going through two pillars. The original title of the book is Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. The Philosopher's Stone, an ancient alchemical concept representing illumination. The rapper Kanye West, standing in the middle of twin pillars in his highly symbolic video, Power. No one means to have all that power. So why do these two females always stand next to him? Especially wearing the same color, because they represent the pillars. And him standing between the pillars represents initiation. That's how you become famous. You have to be initiated into Freemasonry first. Initiation too provides a key that unlocks secret knowledge or information. The key is a symbol of power, a visible sign of this initiation. Being given the keys to a town or city is a great honor, with implications of power and ownership, and has parallels with the medieval custom of handing over the keys as a way of granting power. So what are some of the things you have to do to be initiated? You have to partake in the rituals, especially the ritual orgies. Why do you think all these females just lying around like that? Because they're tired? This is representing the mansion parties and the orgies that they have there. That's why in the background you can see this guy humping. He's not doing that on accident. He's showing you that this is actually what goes on in these mansion parties. This is part of the rituals. What did you think Candy Shop was about? I take you to the candy shop. I let you lick the lollipop. Go ahead, girl, don't you stop. This whole song is about a sex cult. Just look at the video. It's telling us a story. And if we use gematria, the practice of coding numbers into words, Candy Shop synchronizes with a sex cult, because this is exactly what this music video is about. And notice in the beginning of the music video, 50 Cent pulled up in a mansion, just like in the movie Eyes Wide Shut. They had a whole sex cult going on in the mansion.
Well, I suppose you'd like the password.
If you'd like, sir.
Fidelio.
Thank you, sir. We'll run you up to the house.
And this is exactly what Cat Williams was talking about in his special, The Mansion Parties.
Motherfuckers be gay in Hollywood, you never fucking expect it. They be having these big ass mansion parties, and the mansion party, the whole mansion is a party. And then it's a separate party in the little rooms. I ain't been famous that goddamn long. I'm excited as a motherfucker to be at the mansion party. You be looking at all the goddamn rooms, and you fuck around and look in the wrong room and shit.
Girl, what we do. Just between me and you.
What they do, where they do it, and the things they do are just between them. Let's go to the book Behold a Pale Horse by William Cooper, page 79. Most members of the Freemasons are not aware of the Illuminati practices, what is known as secrets within secrets, or organizations within organizations. That is one purpose of the initiation. I cannot excuse any of the members, however, for anyone who joins a society without knowing everything about the organization is indeed a fool. Only those at the top who have passed every test truly knows what the Masons are hiding, thus rendering it impossible for anyone outside to know much at all about the group. What does that say about new members or those who are already members but do not know the ultimate secrets? It tells me that fools abound. Unlike authors who out of fear have acted as apologists for Freemasons, I decline to absolve them of responsibility and guilt. The Freemasons, like everyone else, are responsible for the cleanliness of their home. The occupant of a secret house within a secret house within a secret house cannot clean if he cannot see the number of rooms or what they contain. The oath of initiation into the Freemason states that if secrets are told, the initiate will be murdered.
Girl, what we do. Just between me and you.
Initiates took an oath that absolved them of all allegiance except to the order and stated, I bind myself to perpetual silence and unshaken loyalty and submission to the order. All humanity which cannot identify itself by our secret sign is our lawful prey. That oath remains essentially the same to this day. Every step of Masonry has its ritual initiation, the mildest being at the Blue Lodge level. Even this is bizarre to say the least. In order to join the lodge, each Mason must first be initiated through an initiation ceremony which is similar throughout the world. The typical ceremony begins with the initiate being first divested of his jacket and his tie and any money or metal article he has. His left trouser leg is then rolled up over the knee. His shirt is opened to expose his left breast and his right shoe is removed and replaced by a slipper. The person who is to be initiated will have a blindfold put on him and a noose put around his neck. This is called a cable toe. The blindfolded initiate, they call this being hoodwinked, is brought with the noose around his neck to the outer door of the lodge. The candidate thus attired is said to be in darkness, an allegory of Masonry that signifies that everyone outside of Masonry is in darkness and that only Masons have the true knowledge that will bring light to the world. The term occult comes from the Latin term occultus, which refers to hidden or secret things. It refers specifically to the incursion of a fourth dimension, a spirit realm, into our three-dimensional world. In prior times, the occult referred to knowledge which was available only by going through some sort of secret initiation rites and which could therefore be obtained by only a select few initiates. Therefore, in the broad sense of the word, even groups like Freemasons or the Odd Fellows are occults.
Why do we just assume that all of this infrastructure and entertainment and open information that is beaming all over the place, all the time, into every single home on the planet is exactly what we're told it is? Maybe there are people out there who are more important than us, more powerful and wealthier than us, that are communicating things and seeing things in the world that are meant for only them and not for us. I think it's fucking ridiculous to assume that media has just one purpose, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you think that's weird?